We'll be discussing liquid atomization and spray systems in this course. Sprays are quite commonly used in our everyday life, whether it's a hair spray, whether it's a perfume spray, or more industrially oriented applications would be where every car today has a spray working the engine. Every aircraft engine has fuel spray systems embedded inside the engine that are the primary source of the liquid being introduced into the combustors. Most of the powdered food products that we consume are all manufactured through a spray drying process. In fact, many of the powdered materials that we use are best manufactured continuously through a spray process of some kind. This course is focused on two aspects associated with spray systems: atomization and sprays. Atomization is the process by which bulk liquid sitting somewhere in a tank is introduced into a device called an atomizer, and that atomizer is responsible for the primary dispersion of this bulk liquid into multitude fragments and droplets. Now, typically these droplets vary several orders of magnitude in size. So, we are going to be interested to discover or understand the physics associated with how bulk liquid sitting in a tank somewhere gets dispersed into droplets that vary several orders of magnitude in size. Spray is the second part of this course. Spray processes basically are where I have a droplet laden jet of some kind, a droplet laden gas flow, or sometimes just droplets that are dragging along gas flow. We are going to be interested to understand how these droplets work their way through a gas flow. We are going to be interested to understand at a statistical scale the transport of these droplets and the cooperative effects that arise out of cooperative transport, and the individual effects that arise out of where we have droplets moving ballistically. We are going to be interested in these two aspects, atomization and sprays. Along the way, we are going to look at many different applications. We are going to discuss designs of injectors. We are going to learn the design methodologies underlying a couple of standard classical injector designs. And then we are going to look at CFD models, computational fluid dynamic models, that have become available to understand spray propagation, to understand transport processes in sprays. So, an overview of atomization systems is what this course is going to provide. This is targeted towards students who are interested in learning atomization, sprays, and on a more general scale, multi-phase flows. The course is also targeted towards industry professionals who use spray systems in their devices and are interested in understanding the transport as well as performance of classical spray injectors. So, welcome on board. It's going to be a 12-week course, and hopefully we'll all learn something together. Thank you.